Today, we're going to take you through the process of hazard identification for crystalline silica. Every day, employees work with materials containing crystalline silica in three main forms. Solid form, such as a brick, respirable form, such as mortar, and liquid form, such as slurry. This can lead to exposure to respirable crystalline silica and can have serious consequences on employees' health. As part of a risk management process, it's important that employees identify all sources and even potential sources of respirable crystalline silica in their workplace. When identifying and assessing hazards and making decisions about risk control measures, employees must consult with their employees, including the health and safety representatives. So, what is the difference between a hazardous substance and a crystalline silica substance? Put simply, a hazardous substance is in respirable form, and a crystalline silica substance is not in respirable form. If you work with a hazardous substance, you can review a safety data sheet from the manufacturer or supplier and find crucial information, including the hazard identification for the substance, hazard and precautionary statements, the composition of the ingredients, the suggested exposure controls, the suggested engineering controls, and the suggested personal protective equipment. The labels on containers of hazardous substances can also provide basic information, which is readily accessible by those employees who use it. The basic information includes the identity and proportion of the hazardous substance, pictograms, hazard and precautionary statements, and signal words. Or if you work with a crystalline silica substance, you can review a product data sheet from the manufacturer or supplier and find information including the proportion of crystalline silica contained within the substance, the suggested exposure controls, the suggested engineering controls, and the suggested personal protective equipment. For further information or guidance on hazard identification, you can visit the WorkSafe website.